Hey, what's up, guys? I am Tag. Welcome to our territory. OnePlus is planning to unveil its upcoming mid-range smartphone, the OnePlus Z, in July. It is expected to be an affordable OnePlus smartphone. The OnePlus Z could be powered by a Snapdragon 765G. If you are following our channel, you may know OnePlus is planning to launch a more affordable headset that still promises big power. The phone had recently been listed on Geekbench, which again hinted at OnePlus going with the Snapdragon 765G instead of a MediaTek for the device. This could be paired with Oxygen OS 10 operating system based on Android 10. Now let's talk about the display of OnePlus Z. The display on the phone is tipped to be AMOLED in nature with a screen size of 6.4 to 6.5 inches, running at a refresh rate of 90Hz. Under the hood, the phone is expected to be made available to variants with either 8GB or 12GB of RAM and storage of 128GB or 256GB. The upcoming OnePlus phone first leaked in December 2019. These renders show a phone with a center punch hole display, possibly glass back, and what could be an alert slider like other OnePlus phones. Unfortunately, these renders don't seem to show a headphone port, which is a big disappointment. We have seen flagship ditch the port in recent years, but mid-range devices have largely kept it. We have saw an image that is actually from OnePlus itself, as the firm held a live stream with executives and seemed to show off dummy models. We doubt OnePlus would show off dummy models if the design were representative of future products in the first place. TrueTag also posted a real-world image apparently showing the OnePlus Z, and it is pretty much in line with previous renders. The image shows a center-mounted display cut out as well as flat screen, but it is also seemed to suggest that an in-display fingerprint sensor will be aboard. That technology is only compatible with OLED screen for now. Now let's talk about the camera specification of OnePlus Z. The OnePlus Z is tipped to feature a triple rear camera setup with a 48MP, a 12MP and a 13MP sensor, as well as a laser autofocus system. At the front, there is said to be a 16MP lens. If a smartphone has a main ultra-wide and telephoto lens, it gives you versatility to take photos in a range of different situations. However, most budget smartphones lack the telephoto camera. Instead of favoring a macro or depth sensing snapper, meaning they are not great for long-range pictures. We had liked to see the OnePlus Z come with these three cameras, so the device is great for photography in a range of situations. It is unlikely since the base OnePlus 8 missed this combo, but we can dream. Now let's talk about the specification of OnePlus Z. The OnePlus 8 series packs some impressive specifications, such as Snapdragon 865 processor, plenty of RAM, and even wireless charging. We cannot expect this feature in the OnePlus Z given the apparent lower price tag. However, sometime later, a new rumor popped up suggesting that the OnePlus Z could instead be powered by a Snapdragon 765. It is not clear if OnePlus possibly planned on using MediaTek and then switched, if it always planned to stick with Qualcomm, or if the rumor are not true and MediaTek is still the plan. Other appearance specifications include an in-display fingerprint sensor, 8GB of RAM, 128GB to 256GB of storage, a 4000mAh battery, and 30W charging. Like with high refresh rate screen, there are no 5G phones on the market at the time that are truly affordable, as even the 5G phones with the lowest price tags are actually mid-range in price and with only okay specification too for the plenty of people looking at get 5G connections without having to spend lots of money. A 5G OnePlus 8 Lite would be great. 5G contracts tend to be expensive enough as it is without the headset being pricey too. Until the launch of a Xiaomi Mi 10 Lite later in 2020, OnePlus would have a monopoly on the affordable 5G phone market if the Lite had the connectivity. Let me know down in the comments below what's your thoughts about the OnePlus Z. Thank you for watching. See you next time.